Chapter 12. Now the Lord had said unto Abram, Get thee out of thy country, and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house, unto a land that I will shew thee. And I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee, and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse them that curseth thee. And in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed. So Abram departed, as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him. And Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. And Abram took Sarai his wife, and Lot his brother's son, and all their substance that they had gathered, and the souls that they had gotten in Haran, and they went forth to go into the land of Canaan, and into the land of Canaan they came. And Abram passed through the land unto the place of Shechem, unto the plain of Moreh. And the Canaanite was then in the land. And the Lord appeared unto Abram, and said, Unto thy seed will I give this land, and there builded he an altar unto the Lord. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse them that curseth thee. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse them that curseth thee.
I give it to you from the scripture. For this is the love of God. You say you love God? I'm not going to question your love this morning, but let measure it by what Jesus calls love. For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. 2 John 1:6, and this is love. Do you want to know what love is? Here's the word of God, and this is love, that we walk after his commandments. John 14:14, if you love me, keep my commandments. John 15:10, if you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, even as I've kept my Father's commandment, abide in his love. John 14:21, he that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. Jesus is saying, love for me is obedience to all my words, all my commandments.
Shalom Aleichem, family, and welcome to Called Apart. I wanted to go live today, but I had some technical issues that have pushed me to just make a video real quick. And I don't want to talk about the things that I'm not sure about. I want to impress upon the things that I am sure about right now. And this message is not going to be for everyone. It may not land on every ear and heart, but those who it is meant for, I need to share this. So that if in case the Holy Spirit gives them a nugget that connects to something that I'm saying, we can fellowship on that together. Some say I'm an unconventional motivational speaker. Are you ready? We'll never understand the Bible without understanding Father's lost people. Family, if I may, let me begin first by sharing a quick testimony. I've been a little ill and under the weather. I've had some injuries that have slowed me down considerably and caused a lot of hardship to my life at the present time. But I've given all that up to the Father, and I'm just trying to see what it is that these difficult situations in my life are distracting me from. That's the way the enemy works, and also sometimes our Father is pruning us through trials and hardships in our life in order that we might grow. So I was off to visit a new church. I haven't had a church to call home in quite some time, and I was led to a small body of believers who are a Baptist church, but they come together on Saturday. Before going there, I had something put on my spirit, and I took a lot of the things that I teach and I printed them out in large glossies and put them in a folder. When I ended up arriving at the church, one of the key pieces of information that I had brought with me was a visual and explanation of Zechariah 14 explaining the millennial reign. This was strongly on my heart when I went to FedEx and had this printed out in a large glossy. So I sat down, and as the Reverend approached the front and began to give his sermon, he said, "Turn with me to Zechariah 14. I wasn't too amazed that the Father works like this, and I was almost kind of giddy in my seat by the point that he started saying that he wished he had some visual that he could share on the widescreen, because people don't see what this time really looks like. And I couldn't help but think it sounded as if he was echoing my exact thoughts when I made the meme to begin with. Praise the Most High. Has anybody ever been to Jiffy Lube or recall going and getting their oil changed at the mechanic? The mechanic has to not only change the oil, but they have to take out the filter, which filtered the oil you already had, let it all out, remove the filter, and put a new filter on, and then fill your car back up with oil. So what would happen if they neglected to change the filter, but put fresh oil in? Well, the oil would quickly become corrupt. And this is the example that comes to my mind when I think about us today studying the Word. We've viewed the Word through a lens that is slightly corrupted. You know, the lens being like the filter of the car, or our own mind and understanding. And one of the reasons that I'm sure of what I'm saying is because when I look today and I see clearly that largely the modern day church in the world have not properly identified God's lost and scattered children. And I see how much prophecy that's unfolding and yet to come that's connected to this group of people. And we're not going to get the true understanding of the timing that we're in right now, or the full context of the things that a lot of the prophecies that are yet to come are explaining to us. Friends, if you have wrongly divided everything related to the lost and scattered children, how are you going to properly understand the rest of Scripture, which centers around them all the way up to the millennial reign? And a lot of people say to me, when they look at the things I'm teaching, it seems about race or color or things that really aren't my point. My point is the identification of the people that the Scripture's speaking of. Because when we've properly identified this group, then we'll realize that the Most High still has prophecy that has yet to be fulfilled through them. And we find today that since this has not been done, the modern day church has largely skipped right over a lot of prophecies yet to be fulfilled. You see, in Ezekiel 37, Ezekiel the prophet prophesied that there will be a people that had been sent into bondage with a whole list of identifiers in Deuteronomy 28, which help you to identify the people that the Most High is speaking of. And the prophecy goes to say that these people will be sent into bondage for 400 years and they'll forget who they are. They'll be in a valley of dry bones, but they'll begin to rattle and their bones will shake as they rise to their feet and are covered with flesh, renewed, so to speak. And then once you've identified that point in history, there's a whole set of other prophecies that will connect to that. The restoration and regathering, period. But scripture also says that the Most High is going to punish the nations responsible for what has happened to his children. And it's come to my attention recently through a series of nuggets the Holy Spirit is dropping on me right now that this is more important than ever right now to identify that period of time where these scattered and lost people come out of that 400 years. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? The Most High promised to punish all the nations responsible for what happened to his lost and scattered people. I don't see a lot of description of what that punishment is. But when you look at the current timing that we're in, it's beginning to be clear to me what that punishment is he was referring to. It aligns up with the rest of what's explained as the punishment to the nations in Revelation. You know, and I guess the many will say, oh, we're not supposed to know the hour or the day. Well, the verse goes on to explain that those who are not blind will not be absent the understanding of the season, which is why I say that this message I'm sharing right now is not going to be for everyone. But for those of you who are touched by what I'm saying, and if the Holy Spirit moves in you to open your eyes up to some of the things that I'm mentioning to you, then this was well worth it right now. But shalom. Peace unto you. Keep your lamps full right now. The kingdom of YAH is at hand.